Dear Edith Piaf, the moment you were born in the doorway of some long-forgotten shop, your mother screamed in agony while the pavement was the first thing to hold you. From that point on, it seemed as though your life was to be defined as a Molotov cocktail served in a champagne bottle. Your spirit the bull, your body the china shop, blinded from conitis as a child and abandoned into the hands of your grandmother's brothel where the women sold their souls in ways that made the devil wince. And as a lonely baby screaming from your crib, the angels listened in but did nothing. As your voice was that beautiful, God's ways that mysterious. Soon enough, you were 7 years old and you had heard the girls calling out for a miracle many times before, but for the first time, you could finally see the heavily caked makeup of the velvet voices of the women who had raised you. It was a miracle under a godless roof, and you grew a love for the downtrodden, the hurt, and the rejected, because that was the pain from whence you came. And you sang for the bitter loves that ripped the hearts right off your sleeve and ran away, and for the ones that were ripped from your arms and just bolted it. On bitter days when Hitler invaded France, and on cold winter nights when lonesome bodies were left to go to bed alone, you sang when there was nothing left for you or your country. You sang because you held out hope. Madame Piaf, how did you do it? I ask because I have a heart that's grown bark, carved with initials I can't erase. Perpetually lonely and kept awake from nightmares of a little boy locked inside of a bedroom with tinfoiled windows, a wet bed, and a heavy-handed shadow man wanting to play patty cake with his belt. I've learned attachment issues from an obsessive mind, so I'm constantly writing I wish you were here postcards out of previously rehearsed apology letters, bottled up as a mixed message deep inside and thrown into the rubble of every burning bridge I've left behind, and hopefully they can read the smoke. Madame Piaf, this is one of those nights when lightning strikes twice out of spite and I'm left withdrawing into the nervous alien wearing my skin. Madame Piaf, this is one of those nights when I'm trying to pick up the pieces like fall leaves kicked up by a bitter wind with hands so out of touch. Madame Piaf, this is one of those nights where you would have sang the loudest, where you'd have damned those that doubted you and kept your demons at bay, and with the force of 1,000 brass bells you would have sang because you were a woman who was barely 5'1" and took the name of a sparrow because life never once took you into consideration. And in this darkened vortex we call the earth, you lit a candle with your voice and called it hope. Madame Piaf, avec tout mon cœur, je vous remercie, parce que ta voix ce soir, mon Dieu. And tonight is a night that I'm happy to know I am not alone, so long as we have the ability to find and use our voice. So thank you, Madame Piaf, for singing that candle into existence. Merci, Madame Piaf. Merci.